Hello, and thanks for tuning in to our live webcast on ryersonian.ca. I'm Carly Thomas, and here with me today is Chris MacDonald, Ryerson Business Ethics Professor at Ted Rogers School of Management. Thank you for joining us. So you wrote an op-ed piece this week about Mayor Rob Ford, how he's simply a bad leader, and he needed to be out of office months ago. Your piece was published after the crack admission, but a lot has happened this week, obviously. What's your reaction to the video released yesterday?
Well, I think it's just further, you know, just one more bit of evidence to what we already knew, to what, you know, a lot of people have been saying since back in May, that this is a highly troubled mayor who, you know, whatever the pros and cons might be from a political point of view, he's just not currently able and isn't going to be able to continue doing the job effectively.
And like you said, since May, like, you've called for the mayor to step down. It seems like it's time. And after this week's events, it seems like a lot of people, that's becoming a popular opinion. Mm-hmm. But Ford Nation still exists. Why is that? How can that be?
It's hard to, I mean, political loyalty is a funny thing. And it's clearly there's a group of people out there who think that he represents their interests in some way. And the point I tried to make in the editorial is that, you know, when we elect political leaders, it's not enough for them just to have ideas that you like. They have to have the personal qualities and the leadership qualities that are going to let them actually get the job done. And Ford just isn't demonstrating those leadership qualities. He just doesn't seem to be able to cooperate with people, to build teams, to lead teams. And without that, regardless of how good you think his policy ideas or directions are, he's just not going to get the job done.
In your article, you write about how while Ford has failed as a leader of the city, he is not the only one who should be doing some soul searching. After all, he didn't elect himself. Talk to me about the types of soul searching the City of Toronto needs to do now.
Well, I think, you know, we need to think seriously about what it is that we want in not just an elected head of government, but a leader. We want to think about not just, is this person on the left, is this person on the right? Regardless of their political leanings, are they going to be a mayor that makes us proud? Are they going to be a mayor that has vision? Are they going to be a mayor that has the leadership skills to get the job done?
What are the consequences for the city if he holds his ground and refuses to resign?
I think it's really hard to say. It's so, we have so little precedent for this sort of thing. We don't have a pattern, a historical pattern to look back to. But I think there's all kinds of problems. I think clearly council is going to be less and less functional. I worry also about the ability of the mayor's office to interact with a whole range of stakeholders. Think about the business community. The business community needs to be able to interact with the mayor's office, with City Hall, for economic development purposes, but it's hard to imagine very many business leaders who want to be seen in the same room with the mayor at this point. He's just become such a liability.
It does seem that way. Well, thank you for your insight, Chris, and being with us today.
My pleasure.
We will have more developments on this story as the day unfolds. You can go to our website, www.ryersonian.ca, and follow us on Twitter at the Ryersonian. I'm Carly Thomas. Have a great day.